So, morning students. Today we will continue the topic solid state. In my previous lecture, I had discussed about crystal defects. When we had studied about crystalline solids, then we learned that crystalline solids are those solids in which constituent particles are arranged in a definite geometrical pattern or in a perfectly ordered way. But in actual practice, because of high temperatures, because of other factors during the formation of crystal, arrangement of particles is somehow disturbed from ideal arrangement. And these anomalies, these deviations that are observed from that ideal arrangement, that ideal expected arrangement, is called as crystal defect. And as I told you that these crystal defects are of two types, point defect and line defect. Once we use the term this point, then point refers to the constituent particle which is present in the given solid. It could be a molecule, it could be an ion, it could be an atom, it could be a positively charged metal kernel. Depending on the nature of compound under consideration, point means constituent particle. So point defect refers to the anomaly or abnormality in the arrangement, anomaly in the arrangement of a constituent particle. And line defect refers to when entire row of points has got deviation from ideal arrangement. So as far as our discussion is concerned, we are mainly concerned with point defects. Line defects are not in our course. Now further, these point defects are also called as intrinsic defects or thermodynamic defects because they are mainly observed of high temperatures during the course of crystallization. Point defects are of three types: stoichiometric point defects, non-stoichiometric point defects, and impurity defects. And as the name suggested, stoichiometric defects are those defects because of which stoichiometry of compound is not disturbed. That is, ratio in which constituent particles are present, it is not disturbed. Say, for example, if there is a compound of AB type that contains A plus and B minus, so the ratio of cation and anion is 1:1. This is ideal and expected arrangement. Now, because of defects that had arisen, this ratio is not disturbed. So it is called a stoichiometric point defect. But if because of defect, stoichiometry of compound is disturbed, stoichiometry of compound is changed, means either number of cations is increased or number of anions is increased, then it is called a non-stoichiometric point defect. And finally, we come to the impurity defect. What happens in impurity defect? Some foreign cation or anion is also present in the crystal apart from actual constituent particles. Impurity refers to the presence of some foreign substance. So these are three type of defects. These are the three types of actually point defects. Now, in my previous lecture, I had explained in detail that what are stoichiometric defects and what are their types. Before moving forward, I just give you a brief revision, a brief reminder of that topic. Stoichiometric defects are of four types: vacancy defect and interstitial defect, Frenkel defect and Schottky defect. Out of these four types that I told here, two types, interstitial defects and vacancy defects, are found in molecular solids, and Frenkel defect and Schottky defect is found in ionic solids. In interstitial defect, point leaves its original position and present in interstitial space, and in vacancy defect, point is missing from its original place. Similarly, in Frenkel defect, cation is missing from its original site and is present in interstitial site, and in Schottky defect, equal number of cations and anions are missing. So up to this I had discussed in my previous lecture. Now we come to the another type of defect, which is called impurity defect. So the description of this defect is evident from its name, impurity. When we talk about any impure substance, then this simply refers to the presence of certain foreign substance. Say, for example, if we are talking about impure milk, so it's not pure milk, something else is added. Say, for even it is water, so we call it impure milk. Similarly, if we talk about a crystal and we say that crystal is impure, that means it has something which is apart from the constituent particles. For example, sodium chloride. So if only it is sodium chloride, something else is added. In impurity defect, what happens? Two monopositive cations are missing from their original site, and a dipositive cation is present at one of its sites to maintain electrical neutrality. As it is observed in case of sodium chloride, two of sodium ions are missing from their original site and one strontium ion is present at one of the sites vacated by sodium ions. Say, for example, this is the crystal, this Na plus Cl minus. So this place is vacant. And here a strontium 2 plus ion is present. So two monopositive cations are missing and one dipositive cation is present at one of the sites vacated by those monopositive cations. And since this ion which is present is a foreign ion, is not the part of crystal, so this causes impurity in the crystal and it is called an impurity defect. And since total positive charge remains same, so electrical neutrality of substance is maintained. This is called impurity defect. Now we come to the non-stoichiometric defects. Non-stoichiometric
defects.
So as a result of these defects, stoichiometry of compound is disturbed. Means ratio in which cations or anions are supposed to be present, they are disturbed or they are changed. Now these non-stoichiometric defects are two types. They are of two types. One is called metal excess defect and other is called metal deficiency defect. Now this metal excess defect arises because of two reasons. Due to absence of an anion and due to presence of extra cation in interstitial site. So before going to the details, first we understand these two terms, what is the meaning of metal excess defect and what is the meaning of metal deficiency. Generally these defects are observed in ionic compounds, and with very basic information that you have that an ionic bond is generally formed between a metal and a non-metal. During the course of formation of an ionic bond, metal loses its electrons to form its cation, non-metal accepts the electron to form its anion, and later on these cations and anions, they are arranged in a definite geometrical pattern to make ionic compound or to make ionic crystal, wherein these cations and anions, they are joined together with the help of strong electrostatic force of attraction. Now, in these defects, metal excess defect, ratio of cation is more as expected, means number of anions are reduced. While in metal deficiency defect, number of cation is less as expected from ideal formula. Metal excess means increase in the number of cation, metal deficiency means decrease in number of anion. Then this metal excess defect arises due to two reasons, either due to absence of an anion from the crystal or due to presence of an extra cation in the interstitial space. While metal deficiency defects are observed in the case of those metals which shows variable valencies. Say for example iron. In iron, if it is present in plus 2 state and plus 3 state, iron forms two type of cations in which one has got two positive charge, a dipositive cation and a tripositive cation where 3 plus charge is present. And during the formation of crystal, certain places which are supposed to be occupied by a dipositive cation is occupied by a tripositive cation, and that is how the number of dipositive cation is reduced though electrical neutrality is maintained. So that is how this metal deficiency defect is arised. Now let us understand them one by one. Now this is an ideal ionic crystal where these minus and plus, it represents respective cations and anions that are present in the given crystal. Now in metal excess defect, what happens that some of anions are missing from their actual site. So because of this less number of anion, ratio of cation increases and this metal excess defect is observed. Now in order to maintain electrical neutrality of the crystal, this vacant place is occupied by electron. And these electrons, they absorb energy in visible region and excited to the next higher level and provides color to the crystal. Thereby these places where these electrons are present are called F center or this letter F is taken from the German word Farbe, that means color, or they are called color center. Say for example, if lithium chloride is heated in the presence of lithium vapors, it appears pink. Why this change is observed? Now what happens when lithium chloride is heated in the presence of lithium vapors? So this lithium first changes to lithium plus and electron, then some of the Cr minus ions is lost from the crystal and the place of this Cl- is occupied by this electron. So as Cl- ion is given out from the crystal, metal excess defect arises, and since this electron occupies this space, so electrical neutrality is maintained. Not only electrical neutrality is maintained, this electron which is present at F center or which is present at the site of anion absorbs energy in the visible region, get excited and imparts color to the crystal. And that is how this F center is produced. So F center is the electron which is present at the site of anion in an ionic crystal. And why it is called F center? That letter F is taken from the German word Farbe, that means color. So if we translate it verbally, then F center refers to the color center. The electron which is present at F center absorbs light in visible region and is responsible for the color of crystal. There is another way of producing metal excess defects. Now this is ideal crystal wherein all sites are occupied by respective cations and anions and some additional cation is present in the interstitial site, and to maintain electrical neutrality, same number of electrons are present at other side. So that is how, again, because of presence of this additional cation in this interstitial space, the number of cation is increased. Now we come to the metal deficiency defect. Metal deficiency defect. Now, metal deficiency defect refers to the reduction in number of cation. This is generally observed in those cases where cation shows variable valency. Say, for example, in the formation of FeO. So iron has got 2 charge, 2 plus, oxide iron has got 2 minus ion, and actually the ratio between ferrous ions and oxide ions is expected to be 1:1. But in actual samples of iron oxide, formula is supposed to be 0.930 or Fe 0.960. Means what? 0.93 atom of ferrous ion or 0.93 ferrous ions are present on each oxide ion, or 0.96 ferrous ions are present on each oxide ion. This is actually not possible. This refers that out of 100 oxide ions that are present, 93 Fe2 plus ions are present, and rest of these spaces are occupied by Fe3 plus ions, so that electrical neutrality of substance is maintained. But because of presence of those Fe3 plus ions, the ratio of cation is actually less. Ratio is less than what is expected, and that is how this is called a metal deficiency defect. So I am quite sure you would have understood it. Let me give you a quick revision of the things that I told you today. Non-stoichiometric defects are those defects in which stoichiometry of ionic compound differ what we expect. Say, for example, we expect cation and anion to be present in 1:1 ratio, but either cation is more or cation is less than the expected ideal arrangement. So this is called non-stoichiometric defects. Now, these non-stoichiometric defects are of two types. One is called a metal excess defect, and other is called a metal deficiency defect. In metal excess defect, cation is more than expected, and in metal deficiency defect, cation is less than the expected. And in impurity defects, place of cation which is actually supposed to be present is taken up by any other cation. Say, for example, in sodium chloride crystal, two sodium plus ions are missing. At one of their missing sites, an strontium 2 plus ion is present. So this is all about crystal defects. Now we come to the next topic. Electrical properties of solids. Now, as far as solids are concerned, a large variation in their electrical properties is observed. Broadly, on the basis of electrical conductance, solids are classified into three categories: conductors, semiconductors, and insulators. And we all know this these three terms. Conductors are those substances through which electrical current passes easily. Insulators are those substances which does not allows the passage of electrical current through them. While semiconductors are those substances, a partial current passes, their resistance is very high. So, a part of current or mild current passes through them. And as we know, that current is the flow of charges. So, in conductors, charge is transferred from the one end of the substance to the other end by certain charge carriers like electrons or ions. While same thing is not possible in case of insulators. While in semiconductors, this charge is transferred from one end to other end to certain extent only. So, my dear friends, I am quite sure that with this discussion, you are able to understand what is the meaning of crystal defects, what is the meaning of a point defect, what is the meaning of a line defect, what is the meaning of stoichiometric defect, non-stoichiometric defect, and their various types, subtypes, F-center, etc. Now, in our next discussion, I will go in detail about electrical properties of solids. What are conductors? What are semiconductors? What are insulators? What are the structural features of solid that makes them a conductor or insulator or a semiconductor? We will discuss these things. By the time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.